Once you've wrestled, everything else in life is easy. On the mat, winning is simple to define.
Gable into the chicken wing. There's the ball. It's all over, Dan Gable.
Your hand gets raised, or it doesn't. As I wrestled my way through high school and college, my hand was raised 181 straight times. Until my last college match.
That's the champion, Dan Gable.
When it wasn't.
He's got him down. And Dan Gable is bewildered. Gable has lost.
181-1. That was my record. But a record isn't what defines a wrestler.
Dan Gable talks about the three periods in wrestling. The first period is won by the guy with the most technique. The second period is won by the guy with the most conditioning.
Yeah, go ahead and put him on the mat.
The third period is won by the wrestler with the most heart. I challenge you to find a wrestler with more heart than Willie Burton.
You can tell when somebody's a wrestler. They walk differently, they talk differently. They're like a little different on the inside.
Over the past 4 years, Willie has wrestled more than 100 matches. And more than 100 times, he lost. Fairdale, Kentucky is just south of Louisville. It's where the odds have always been stacked against Willie from before he was even born.
His birth mom called our church one day and she said, I'm 17, I'm pregnant, I want to know if someone in your church will adopt my baby.
We were going back and forth, weighing the pros and cons and everything, and then we finally decided that we would take him.
On September 23rd, 1995, Willie was born. He was 2 months premature.
I have a cerebral palsy. It's because I had a bleed in my brain, the part of my brain that tells me how to walk, and it also affects my speech too.
Willie's legs would never freely support his body weight. And he had limited strength and grip in his right arm.
Pediatric therapy, family care center.
I had a physical therapy pretty much every day of the week. A couple days out of the week, I had to have physical therapy and I had speech therapy.
Willie's mental capacity was unaffected. And he always tried to do more than his body would allow.
He's always wanted to be involved in sports. We tried handicap sports, and that was boring.
I got one first place and one second place.
But they're not competitive enough. Like, you tried your best, and here's a trophy. I want to do something greater than that.
In 2010, Willie started high school. That's where he found the competition he had always been seeking.
When I got to high school, I just wanted to wrestle just because I want to do a sport where it's me against the other guy, and whoever wins, wins.
Okay, that was good. I got you.
I asked him, you sure you want to do this? And he said, yeah.
It's hot outside.
I told him, I said, I'll support you in any way I can.
Yeah. Yes. Kick off.
I was scared for him because I was figuring this ain't going to happen.
After passing a physical, Willie joined the team.
When I saw Willie, and I saw the struggle, and, you know, could barely crawl from one end of the mat to the other, and I just told him, I said, man, I don't know how that's going to work out.
I presented Willie with the same challenges I would have with any wrestlers. Whatever happened inside that circle was completely left to him. He wasn't treated with any kind of special treatment. Wrestlers weren't asked to throw in the towel for him.
And nobody did. Wrestling at 106 pounds, Willie had a strong upper body. But he had limited control of his right arm and had no use of his legs on the mat. He wrestled more than 20 times as a freshman. He lost every match.
I was all the time waiting, and I'm sad to say it, I was actually hoping that one day he'd come home and go, "Hey, Dad, wrestling's not for me."
Instead, when off-season conditioning began, Willie pushed even harder.
Here was a kid willing around the track for 2 miles. I mean, his hands were bleeding, and he never said a word.
I didn't want to give up. I didn't want to say, okay, just because I didn't win. Okay, I'm not doing this anymore. I want to be known as a wrestler.
By his sophomore season, he was.
He began to gain confidence. And I think it gave everybody else the opportunity to be able to see Willie's personality.
Carrying Willie and everything, it was a hassle. But it was kind of our hassle, you know. We enjoyed doing all that. You'd get weighed in, and then one or two kids that had to redress him.
Because I felt like I belonged to the team. I was one of the members. I was one of the brothers.
Get him, Willie, get him. Come on, Willie.
But once Willie was on the mat, his teammates could only watch.
You know, there was always that hope that he would pin somebody or win by points. And, you know, it never came.
Heartbreak. To watch him crawl out there, you know, and be hoping, you know, you're thinking maybe this would be the time, you know. And he would lose.
Sophomore year. Junior year. Every match, he lost.
There was times I wanted to give up. I mean, if I'm not going to win, what's the point of doing this?
Senior year was no different. The season was coming to an end. Willie remained winless.
I have to figure out what I want my legacy to be here. Do I want it to be a kid that hasn't won? Or do I want to push harder than I ever have before?
February 11th, 2014.
I thought it was going to be like any other night. You know, Willie's going to go out, and he's going to be ready to wrestle. But, you know, he's going to not be able to win.
Gets toward the middle. You know, really close match.
No, drive, Willie, drive.
I mean, it just got electric.
The referee's eyebrows are going up, and people are standing.
You just want to will him through it, you know?
The final period. The match is tied. Willie secures a cradle.
He can win this. He can win this.
Willie turns his opponent's shoulders on the mat and takes the lead. First time in over 100 matches, Willie's hand was raised in victory.
It meant that all my hard work didn't go to waste, and it wasn't just for no reason.
Go in, Willie. Don't give him nothing, Willie.
4 days later, regionals.
It kind of hit me like, if I don't win this, this is my last match I'm ever going to have.
So, this ain't your last match. You got this.
Let's go, Willie. Use your hands, the base. After 40 seconds, it was over.
His never say die attitude has caused me to look at myself and say, don't you dare quit.
I only have one loss. Willie only had one win. But our records don't define us. We are both champions. We are both wrestlers.
You can tell when somebody's a wrestler. They walk differently, they talk differently.
Once you've wrestled, everything else in life is easy. On the mat, winning is simple to define.
Evil Inner's chicken wing. There's the ball. It's on over, Dan Gable.
Your hand gets raised. 181 and 1. That was my record. But a record isn't what defines a wrestler.
Dan Gable talks about the three periods of wrestling. The first period is one by the guy with the most technique.
You to find a wrestler with more heart than Willie Burton.
You can tell when somebody's a wrestler. They walk differently, they talk differently. They're like a little different on the inside.
Over the past 4 years, Willie has wrestled more than 100 matches. Or it doesn't. As I wrestled my way through high school and college, my hand was raised 181 straight times until my last college match. When it wasn't.
Second period's won by the guy with the most conditioning.
Yeah, go ahead and put him on the mat.
The third period is won by the wrestler with the most heart. Challenge.